Welcome back guys. In this video tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to set up a sensor that is HP203B. In the previous videos, we have seen working on the different digital sensors. So similarly, we will be proceeding further this momentum and we'll be working on new sensor that is HP203B. So for that, first of all, go to the website that is controleverything.com and here search for this sensor. And let's see what we got. So HP203B is a precision barometer and altimeter sensor, and these are some of its features. As you can see, you can purchase this sensor as you can see on my screen. Further, I will be showing the interfacing of this sensor with an Arduino Nano, and for that I require a code. So for that, go to the source tab and here's our Arduino code sample. You can get the Arduino code sample as a zip file from here, from this own website. You have the chance to get the code from our GitHub repository that is Control Everything Community. So what we now need to make connections for the hardware we require for this particular video tutorial. So for that, let's move forward. This is our required sensor, that is HP203B. In addition to this, we would need an Arduino Nano, which you are able to see on my screen. Now, to provide the solution of connection among the sensor and the Arduino Nano, and to further make the connection a lot easier, and for the other I2C devices, we need this I2C shield. Now, this is available on our website controleverything.com, and gently press the Arduino Nano over the I2C shield and make this connection. Now, the binding factor of the connectivity within the sensor and the I2C shield is this connecting cable. Now make the connection of the cable and the sensor like this, and while making this connection, make sure that the brown wire of the cable should be connected to the ground terminal of the sensor, and similarly this suit has to be followed for the I2C shield. Now it looks like this. Next, we might need to power up our Arduino Nano, and for that we require a mini USB cable, just like this. Gently put it over the power jack of the Arduino Nano. Hence, we are done with our connections part. Now this is a setup we require, and now when I power up the Arduino Nano, it will light it up. So the connection setup is completed. Now let's have a look over the code we want to interface with our sensor, and let's have a roll ahead. As we are done with the connections part for the hardware, next, we require an Arduino code so that we can interface our sensor with an Arduino Nano. So for that, first of all, log in to github.com, and next we have to search for Control Everything Community, which is the official repository for controleverything.com. Here, type in the sensor name which we want to interface, and here it comes. Now this is the required Arduino code. Let's have a look for the instruction for this code. We have to download and install Arduino software on our local machine, and this is the link which will help us to install the software. So let's have a look for this particular link, and here it comes. As you can see, we can download the Arduino software from here, and in the Windows, Mac or Linux operating system, whatever your choice is. All the relevant information is being provided, and it will help us to install the software step by step. So go through it carefully. Now get back to the code. And here is our Arduino code, which is a .ino extension file. The first thing you notice in the code is that we have included wire.h library, which will help us to have all the functions relevant to this particular code. And we have defined the address of the sensor, that is 0x76. In the void setup function, we have initialized I2C communication as master and initialized serial communication with the baud rate equal to 9600. And there is a delay function of 300 ms there. Now in the void loop function, we are in the writing section part. So we have sent an OSR and channel setting command, and the writing section is for here. Next, we want to read the data. Now for that, we have selected the data register, that is 0x10. Now here we have requested and read 6 bytes of data that include temperature and pressure. We are being continuously reading data and collecting the data for the conversion of the values, and this is the conversion part of the data for temperature and pressure. And why we use this formula is that we have been instructed in the data sheet to use this particular set of values. So let's get it done. And in the next part, there's again a command to send OSR and channel setting command. The writing section is here, as you can see. Now this is for the second priority, that is altitude. Now we are reading the data from 0x31 data register, and we have requested and read 3 bytes of data, as you can see, for the altitude. Similarly, we have converted the data which is according to the formula we are being provided in the data sheet for HP203B. At the very end of our code, we have output data on the serial monitor, and we have formatted it, as you can see, altitude in meter, pressure in Pascal, temperature in Celsius, and temperature in Fahrenheit scales again. Now this is how Arduino code looks like for HP203B. Now it's a very generalized and simple code, as you can see. You can have a go through for this code. Now what we need is to show how to interface this code with the sensor, how it works. So for that, let's have a go through once again. Now I'm gonna interface the sensor with the code and show how it works. So for that, first of all, copy this entire Arduino code and open up the terminal. Now save the code and name it HP203B, and now verify and compile the code. It's good. Now upload the code. It sometimes takes a while to upload, so let's wait, and it's done. Now to check the monitor for the output, let's open up the serial monitor, and here it comes. As you can see, altitude, pressure, and temperature. Now when I apply some pressure over the sensor, as you can see, there's a change in altitude, pressure, and temperature. Now it's again dropping. Now when I again apply some pressure over the sensor, there's again change in altitude, temperature, and pressure. So this is how an Arduino code works for the sensor HP203B using an Arduino Nano. So let's roll up on and see what are the features, benefits, and why do we use this particular sensor. We have seen the working of the sensor, the code, and a lot more for the sensor HP203B. The HP203B employs a MEMS pressure sensor with an I2C interface to provide accurate temperature, pressure, or altitude data. The sensor pressure and temperature outputs are digitized by a high resolution 24-bit ADC. The altitude value is calculated by a specific patented algorithm according to the pressure and temperature data. Now, these are the features. Due to this, it's viable for a lot of applications like mobile altimeter, barometer, industrial pressure and temperature sensor systems, weather station equipment, indoor navigation and nap assist, and a lot more. You can purchase this sensor from the website controleverything.com, and you can get the relevant code by going to the resource tab and then downloading it. Now you can also get the code from the GitHub repository, that is Control Everything Community. Now I have shown you the working explanation, hardware connections, and a lot in this video tutorial. In case if you have any doubts and queries, you can contact me on controleverything.com, and be sure to post your comments on the community page. Now for blogs and articles, you can check me on instructables.com, and to subscribe more video tutorials like this, go to our YouTube channel. At the very end, I hope you found this video useful and yourself a good one. Enjoy yourself. Thanks for watching.